This will likely be my final update about the east-west rail route between Bicester and Bletchley. Not a great deal has changed since my last visit in January when the final rails were installed, but I did want to talk about the Aylesbury link a little bit in this video, which I will do towards the end. There's just a few points I wanted to raise. Testing on the line is now well underway and the first test trains ran on a large section of the route in August. I'm not sure if a test train has yet run the whole route from Bicester to Bletchley, but it certainly ran on large sections of the route, checking that all the clearances are okay and checking the equipment such as signalling and switches are all working. Two key road bridges have now been fully complete. I believe Addison Road actually opened quite some time ago, but during my visit a few weeks ago, it was yet again closed. I'm not sure what the reason was for this closure, but I know there have been issues with land access and utility diversions, which caused the delays to the opening of the bridge. The road that runs north up from Skull Hill past the Calvert Jubilee Nature Reserve has been realigned to run underneath the east-west rail tracks rather than before where it ran over on an old stone bridge. Now for the life of me, I can't figure out what the name of this road is. I have looked on various maps, I've even looked on the Bucks County Council website and there doesn't seem to be a name for this road. If you know what the road's called, then please do let me know in the comments because it's really been bugging me, or if it doesn't have a name at all. The main works for Addison Road and Main Street were delivered by the EKFB joint venture on behalf of HS2. And this was due to the interface with the infrastructure maintenance depot and east-west rail tracks. I may revisit the depot at some point, but at the moment there isn't a great deal to see, with much of the work just focusing on earth moving and preparing the site for the construction of the depot. The main civils for this section were delivered by EKFB last year, and the tracks, as I reported in January, were fully laid on the route by the east-west rail company. Winslow Station is now largely complete, with the finishing touches being carried out to the drop-off facilities, and the structure for what is the multi-storey car park was complete during my visit at the end of August, and the deck was being finalised and sealed when I visited. The two-storey car park will have 365 spaces, which seems like quite a lot, but it will draw in people from the surrounding area. Now I know parkways are a bit out of fashion these days, but with Winslow being the only intermediate station on the route, it will undoubtedly bring in passengers from the surrounding hamlets and villages which surround Winslow. And this of course means people won't have to drive to places like Bicester, Bletchley or Milton Keynes to access rail services. So it will have an added benefit, although I just hope the car park is big enough. I wasn't able to visit Bletchley this time around, but the main structure was completed some time ago and trains have operated through the new high-level platform since then. Beyond those updates, the rest of the line hasn't changed much, and as I said, the tracks were laid in January. So really, most of the work is now complete. Everything's just little finishing touches to the bridges like at Addison Road and things like that. So not a great deal to see in terms of an update. So now it's a little bit of a waiting game for the first passenger train to start operating at some point next year. Moving away from the main east-west rail route, I did want to talk a little bit about the Aylesbury link. This would see a connection from east-west rail along the old Great Central Alignment, which could potentially connect Aylesbury with Milton Keynes, which would provide benefits for passengers who want to travel north or for people who are travelling from the north to places like Aylesbury. I know personally myself, I've had to travel to Aylesbury quite a few times over the past 12 months. It really would have been a handy link because at the minute, the only way to get to Aylesbury and Wendover from the north usually means travelling into London. And if you're trying to get there early on, then obviously travelling into London can be expensive. So it would have a great benefit. I know Aylesbury and Wendover aren't top destinations, but it just would provide an extra level of connectivity, which would mean no longer having to travel into central London to then have to travel north out of central London again. Now, Currently, School Hill in Calvert is closed while a new bridge is being constructed. And this is being done by EKFB, obviously, because it's part of the HS2 route. When I visited in August, you could quite clearly see that the piling had been complete and what looks like the pouring of the ground slab commencing. In this clip, you can see that the two-span structure will have enough space for two pairs of tracks, so four tracks in total is possible, with the possibility of building an Aylesbury link in future. But there does seem to be a little bit of a misconception that the construction of HS2 means the link can't be constructed. This couldn't be further from the truth, because HS2 are actually doing a lot of work to enable a link to the bridges, such as the one over School Hill is being built wide enough for the HS2 tracks and for a link in future. And also further down the route, HS2 will be putting in passive provision for a link to possibly be constructed. The main sticking point for the Aylesbury link isn't anything to do with HS2, it's to do with DfT funding. And before the election, the Conservatives definitely were not considering funding the link anytime soon, as it's not viewed as a priority. It's impossible to tell what Labour will do with regards to the link. I don't think they've mentioned it at all. I'm not sure if they've mentioned East-West Rail much, to be honest. But that link, unfortunately, doesn't seem to be a funding priority. But just to reiterate that HS2 has nothing to do with the delivery of the route, and in fact makes it more deliverable, if anything. I'm not currently sure where Labour stands on the extension of the East-West Rail route to Cambridge. I don't think that's been mentioned much either, but if they do provide an update, I will also be providing an update about the future of that route. I think the only thing we know for certain is that funding was provided before the election for the upgrade of the Marston Vale line from Bletchley to Bedford. As far as I know, that funding is still in place. Now, it doesn't provide the full upgrade which is required for the Bletchley to Bedford section. I think it means either two or three trains per hour could operate on that route once some of the upgrades are completed. So, as far as I know, that funding is still there, but with regards to the rest of the route, I'm not entirely sure what Labour has planned. Everything seems to be up in the air at the minute. So that was just a brief update about the East-West Rail route. Now that the tracks are in place, not a great deal to see on the ground, or not much has changed since January anyway. But it will be exciting once the first passenger trains, even when testing starts, I might provide a quick update. But with regards to visiting the actual East-West Rail site, I don't have any plans over the next couple of months. But I will definitely be providing an update on East-West Rail going further east once Labour finally makes an announcement.